All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to the Southern Motor Works channel here on YouTube. As I said on the previous video towards the end there, today we're going to be working on my personal SUV. The project for today is going to be clearing up the headlights. As you see, they've yellowed pretty bad. They're pretty hazy. They don't really have the distance that they used to. So today we're going to be using a special kit and trying to clean them up as best we can. Just kind of trying to make them last a little bit longer before we actually buy some brand new lenses for it and stuff. So, all right, we'll follow along. We'll show you the process. Alright, so as you can see, like I said, they're yellowed pretty bad. The lenses don't really have the distance they used to as far as you know, shining down the roadway at night. Here where we're at now here in the Florida Panhandle, the deer population is pretty thick. So every day on the way to work, we pass, you know, tons of deer. So if we can get a little bit more distance out of it, that'll be all the better for trying to avoid, you know, hitting the deer in the middle of the night. So like I said, this is my personal SUV here, 1999 ML430. First video this one's really been in, I think there's a couple shorts or something like that I've posted that involve it, but this is really like kind of the first full-length video showing anything with it. But we'll do a quick walk around, we'll kind of show you what we're dealing with her. So like I said, it's a 99 Mercedes ML430, so 4.3 V8. 5-speed automatic trans. It does have a little bit of work done to it. It's kind of a work in progress still. Front torsion bars are cranked, not all the way to the max, just, you know, because then it makes the ride a little bit too uncomfortable, but they are cranked pretty high. The back's got 20 millimeter spacer pucks in it, sitting on 265/70/17s. The wheels are 17x8 ESM 004s. I don't even think they make them anymore. You could probably still find some aftermarket, but I think as far as brand new ones, that's about it. They're not too bad. They have a plus 20 millimeter offset, so it kind of kicks the tire out a little bit closer to the, you know, a little bit past the edge, more than what it would have been factory anyway. It's kind of a little bit of an Overland build, you know, luggage rack on the back. It's got a custom spare tire carrier that I fabbed up and mounted on the back. Yeah, that's about it so far. The bumpers are trimmed to clear the bigger tires and everything. This one does have some plans. I have plans for this in the future. Eventually it's going to be, you know, probably on 35s. We'll probably have some custom bumpers fabbed up. One of my favorite aspects of this truck though is the dual side pipes, G-Wagon style side pipes here. So they do sound quite nice whenever you're cruising down the road. But as you can see, being up north in the salt states kind of took its toll on her a little bit. She's gonna have to get resprayed now. I mean, I've got, you know, that salt, it does a number on paint jobs, it really does. You see up there up on top by the sunroof, and kind of hurt the luggage rack a little bit. But now that we're back down here in Florida, we'll get her back up to snuff, so to speak. So, but for today, project's gonna be, let's get these hazy yellow lenses cleared up and see how much better the light's gonna look through them there. But first off, we're gonna go ahead and mask off the area around the light and everything, try to protect what little bit of paint's left there, so. All right, we're just using a little bit of just some general purpose masking tape here. It doesn't need to be anything too fancy. We're just trying to kind of keep from scratching up any of the surfaces around the lenses there. like I said, you just kind of want to stick it in there right around anywhere where the sanding discs that we're going to be using might kind of, you know, where you might miss a little bit there and run into the edge of the paint a little bit. Eventually this is going to get resprayed. I'm thinking we'll probably go with some kind of a Rhino liner or something like that on it. Just I mean, it's not a show truck. It's not going to be a show truck. It's not really the what we're going for with this. Like I said, it's mostly like an overland rig. I take this thing out camping and fishing and, you know, that kind of thing. So that's really what we're kind of going for on it. So like I say, you just want to kind of mask them off like that. We're mostly just getting in the center here. So mask off the second side here. Okay, so now that we've got both of those kind of masked off, just to protect what, you know, paint is actually still there, let's show you the kit that we're going to be dealing with. Never mind all the wood pieces everywhere, we're kind of right smack dab in the middle of building a big old chicken coop out there. So that's from a little laying hens. We've got I think 17 birds right now, so kind of getting a little, you know, a little bit of a chicken farm started anyway, just for personal use for right now. So but anyway, so the kit we're going to be using today is the Mother's New Lens kit. I've never used this one before. I've used, like, I think the Turtle Wax one and Meguiar's. Never used the Mother's before, but we'll give this one a try and see how it turns out. Now, this entire kit here is actually used with a power drill. So we have the plastic polish in there. And we have instructions, obviously. Probably a good idea to read those, I suppose. And got a couple sanding discs and the little holder, obviously, for the sanding discs. A polishing ball of some sort here. All right, so first things first here, it looks like to start out with, we're going to be using the sanding disc like this. We'll go ahead and attach that. And apparently it says you're supposed to set it to low. We're going to start out with an 800 grit sanding disc here. Right there. I don't know if you can see that. Alright, so according to this, you're supposed to spray water on. Let's see if I can get our freaking spray bottle working here. Supposed to soak down the headlight real good. We'll go ahead and spray some on the sanding disc also. And then, yeah, we just hit it with the sanding disc. This is the roughest grit, so this is going to take off the largest amount of haze and all the really big stuff like that. And then we'll just progressively go up to a higher grit from there. You really want to start kind of in the middle and just go back and forth on passes and then kind of spread out from there. And as you can already see some of the yellow hazy stuff coming up. The water's no longer clear there. So it's definitely doing its thing here. We'll continue. Now we'll kind of wipe it off and see here. It should have a kind of uniform sort of, should be hazy across the whole thing. Because, you know, we just sanded it, so it should look like it's been sanded across the whole thing. I mean, it's not bad, but I think we could do with one more pass on it there. So we'll hit it one more time with the sanding disc. That's looking pretty uniform across the whole thing there. So now we'll move on, go ahead and move on to the next step. Okay, so the next step calls for the 1500 grit. So we're gonna get that on there. We'll respray the lens with water. Spray a little bit on the disc itself. And repeat the process. What I'm doing is just kind of make a good pass all over everything, then I'll spray it down with more water. Keep rolling. Okay, so now we'll spray the whole thing down with water. Gonna rinse it off real good. Give it a nice wipe down. We'll see where we're at. It's definitely looking better. I mean, it's wet right now, but you can already kind of see. It's definitely clearing up versus before. So we'll keep going on with the next step here. All right, so we've got our lens all dried up and everything here. As you can see, it's pretty, it's got a nice even haze across the whole thing. So now we're going to be moving on to our, what is it, 3000 grit sanding disc here. And it says, make sure it's dry. Run at 1300 to 1700 RPMs with light to moderate pressure. All right, and then we just go through this, and just says to make sure it has nice even haze afterwards. So we'll go ahead and do this real quick. As you can see, we're already starting to see it's clearing up pretty well in there. So even before the polishing phase, which is the next step. Okay, so the next step is we're going to be using the foam polishing tool and the plastic polish cream here. So we pretty much just run over the entire surface with this, polish it back and forth however many times it takes, and then we brush it with a nice like microfiber cloth or something like that, and that's going to be pretty much all there is to this. So we'll take this, our 3000 grit off there, attach our polishing, foam polishing wheel here, make sure it's on real good. Now you don't need a whole lot of the polishing paste. The last thing you want to do is put a huge glob of it on there, and then as soon as you start spinning the drill, it just slings everywhere. It's a mess. It's no fun. So we will it's a little windy today. So we'll start out with a little bit of it on the ball here, if I can figure out how to use this. Well, what is the deal? Oh, okay. Well, nice. So there's a little seal in there, but it was kind of trapped in the top of the squirt bottle part there, so. By the kit, be aware of that. So now, start out with just a little bit right in the center there, and that's really all you need to start out with. Start out kind of slow. Speed up after a minute here. And I'm kind of doing this in sections. We'll hit like the turn signal part over here. We'll hit the main high beam and low beam part here. And then I'll hit the fog lamp area over here last. Just that way we're not trying to do too much of a surface area with, you know, not enough polish on there. Okay, so we're back. Actually, I had to step away for a second. Drill battery died, so we'll just use the impact real quick. It'll be fine. Okay. Okay, so let's get you in for a little bit closer look here. That is quite a bit of a difference versus the other side over here. Yeah, that's not too bad at all. So let's get a nice microfiber cloth or something here, and we will wipe it off real good, polish it up. Alright, so we'll give this a good wipe here. See what we're dealing with 100%. Alright. That is not too bad at all. Not too bad at all, if I do say so myself. So, let me go turn the headlights on here. As you can see, quite a bit of a difference over the left-hand side here. The right-hand side, I should say. The passenger side. Yeah, that is not too bad at all. Lower it down a little bit here and see. Yeah, that's not too shabby. I think that'll work just fine. So we'll go on ahead and move on to the next side. And we'll just speed that up a little bit since you already know the process. So. Okay, and I just wanted to point out one thing on here that I can definitely say is one of my favorite parts about this kit so far. They actually give you two each. So one per side of the 1500 and 800 grit pieces of, or sanding discs, I guess you call them. You know, a lot of these kits, they give you just like one disc or, you know, or it'll be one piece of sanding cloth or something like that. And what'll end up happening is the first lens that you do, obviously, you know, gets the full grit and everything works fine. But the second one you do, by the time you get around to the second one, the sandpaper, sanding discs, whatever, already clogged up with material. So the second lens, you have to work twice as hard or it just doesn't get done, you know, nowhere near as good as the first lens. So it is a nice nice addition that these kits actually have, you know, two discs, one for each side. So when you start out with the second lens, you know, you're starting out with a fresh disc again and not one that's already been used. So I do like that. That's a kudos to mothers on that one. Alright, so we'll go ahead and give this a quick spray down. Go ahead and get started on the second lens here. Now on this one, you want to go a little bit slower with these first couple discs. So you don't want to go quite as fast as the third disc and the polish. We'll be right back. fiber cloth. See how it really turned out here. That is not too shabby right there for 25-year-old lenses, almost 25 years old. Not too bad at all. Not too bad at all. Boy, this stuff kind of makes a bit of a mess though. Slings that stuff all over the place. So kind of be aware of that in case there's anything that you don't want it to get on. So now let me walk inside. We will turn the headlights on. Let's see how much better it looks. All right, so as you can see, it is definitely better, definitely brighter now. Ooh, yeah, definitely brighter. I think they came out pretty well even. You can see all down inside the lens and everything now, so there's bound to be an improvement come morning time for watching out for deer in the morning on the way to work. So anyway, so yeah, so that's it. I will I'll probably include a little bit of nighttime footage or put it in a short later or something like that so we can really see how bright they are. It's kind of hard to get a good judgment of it out here in Florida right now. It's pretty darn bright right here in the middle of the day. So I'll include a little bit of footage of that either at the end of this video or, like I said, in a short later or something like that. But anyway, but thank y'all for following along with us. Hopefully maybe this will help somebody. You can pick up that kit. It's a $20 kit. It's a heck of a lot cheaper than buying new headlight lenses. So if it gets you by or gets you a little bit of extra time before you have to buy those expensive lenses, then, you know, all the better. So, all right. So anyway, appreciate y'all following along. Head on over to the Southern Motorworks channel if you haven't already. Give us a like and subscribe if you enjoy the content. And keep an eye out for new content, and we're going to try to post regularly, like every Thursday afternoon, Thursday evening, something like that. So make sure you click that bell so you can get alerts whenever we post new content and whatnot. And we'll see y'all on the next project. Y'all have a good one out there.